I want to talk about the problems between the community and the
Because I've previously mentioned the problems between the NEETdom and the unnecessary vilification that NEETs get when they need positive reinforcement all the time to move on in life and get that job, or that training, or that education. But ultimately, that means of making money to move on. And we see this vilification moving more towards incels now, and people who are aware of the fact that they're not having sex anymore. But even more so than that, I want to talk about problems that a lot of people simply put do not want to admit that you really can get labeled for. A problem that I thought I would lose the moment I broke out of NEETdom, the moment I got employed and learned skills to make money on my own, that problem is becoming institutionalized. You see, for a lot of people, they become institutionalized the moment they get too deep on that K-12 education that they go through for 13 years. It has affected me. For a lot of people, that might not affect them because they've moved on to be institutionalized by the military. Or I'm noticing for a lot of YouTubers nowadays, they're being institutionalized as ex-cons by the prison system that they've been in, the penitentiary, for 5+ years. Like, I'm looking at channels like Lockdown 2031, and this dude's super institutionalized. Like, he's still eating the way he did back in the day. He's still keeping in contact with other ex-cons, trying to link up with other people from that part of his life. And for a lot of us, that's a very terrifying thought. That the rest of your life is sort of becoming an epilogue, less and less going on, because you're not moving on to the next chapter in your life. And even scarier, I see it on YouTube with some people who are deep into the corporate lifestyle. And all their friends are in these big industries doing the same middle management stuff. And that's the most depressing of them all. However, in my case, even though I'm 23, 5 years ago I completed my K-12 experience, and I am still being affected by the habits that I picked up in there. Now, I've made new friends. Yet I am so institutionalized by that K-12 experience in a very terrifying way, because I have reoccurring dreams at least once every month pertaining to those final exams, those semesters, that feeling of being a classroom, not really wanting to be there, not really wanting to see the same people every day. And it's a very annoying dream that I keep getting every month. There's variations at least. And no two variations are too similar to be redundant, but just the feeling that even though I've moved on a superficial level, my subconsciousness is still affected by that. A lot of the experiences that I've had back in those days, middle school, high school, even elementary school, still affect me on a subconscious level. And it's not all bad, because at least in the case of my elementary school, people I know from back then that I kept in contact with were actual childhood friends. People that I grew up with, they lived next door to me or across the street. So being friends with them has an extra touch of being human and not really jeopardizing or infringing on my psychological freedom. But when it comes down to the fact that I'm still having dreams of being these annoying ass classmates, oftentimes the classes that I hated, often taking semesters that I feel are completely unnecessary, it's annoying. And I have a personal friend from some of my newer relationships who is being, he's still affected by being institutionalized, like being 12 education. Not so much the dreams, but the fact that he's actually trying to maintain that same level of friendship with people he only knew from those 4 years in high school. And if you only know them from high school, I'm going to tell you straight off the bat, and those aren't your childhood friends, you've got to be like elementary school, kindergarten, on the same block. If you went to the park, you saw him. If you went to the corner store, you saw him. He's trying to still link up with these people when they're probably out of state in college or doing other interesting things in life or being institutionalized by other institutions. And this is a big issue I have with identity, because how do you maintain healthy relationships? Relationships that will eventually give you a family, or a family outside of your family, like a real family outside of your family, not just an unhealthy surrogate. True friendships from people who actually care about you, not just people who are around you when it's convenient, because you don't want to burn bridges and shit. People who actually have love in their heart. You can't build a strong foundation of these relationships out of being obsessed with the past. You have to move on to the future. That's why I love making friendships with people, like new people. That's why I love learning new skills. That's why I love finding new ways of making money and shit, but the fact that I'm having these reoccurring dreams, that's not something I want to continue to have. And it's even scarier when I see people who were from the military, probably developed some PTSD, were surrounded by people who were willing to shoot and get shot for them. Those bonds are so strong that even though all of that is over and the wound is broken, they still want to latch onto those people on the chance of death, or who is in the pen, or who is in the corporate world. That sort of stuff is horrifying. I remember having another alt-right friend who thinks that you're becoming institutionalized, that you're a shit. You're a shit dude with a dead-end job. Do you still feel like high school and the rest of your life? That's scary too. He finds that absolutely mortifying. I myself despise K-12 education, but in my case that doesn't make it any better, because the fear is still lingering in my subconscious. All those exams, boring classrooms, teachers that didn't stand, classmates that didn't stand, because I knew they hated my guts and shit. So, it doesn't matter how you feel about these places. No one really likes being in prison, but you see these ex-cons who never seem to shut the fuck up about it on YouTube. So, it's something where you gotta really admit that there's a problem there, and make steps to break out of it, and find the next chapter in your life. I've been in boarding school at 7, Oh, and these are the homework assignments for some of you. Find out why I still have the exit. I got the exit from 2017. I've done all sorts of shit. I drank more water and I've used benzo. Why do I still have this specific zit on my face? It's fucking annoying.